Aleluia. Father, we bless your name. To you we give all the glory, to you we give all the honor, to you we give all the adoration, Lord. Ya pasakata urukuti, ya brukusete rebulia, ya sakata puya. Father, to you be all the glory, to you be all the honor, to you be all the adorations. We magnify your holy name, O Lord. You are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be worshipped. You are worthy to be adored, O Lord. Kita puli baba kaskende yetulia. Pasuka te puli baba kaskende lebo. Blood of Jesus. Overshadow our lives this afternoon. In the name of Jesus. And cleanse us from all unrighteousness. In the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire. Overshadow our lives this afternoon. And let every serpent of destruction begin to run out and begin to run into fire. Begin to run out and begin to run into fire. Begin to run out and begin to run into fire. Begin to run out and begin to run into fire. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire. Overshadow my life. Overshadow this meeting. And let every serpent of darkness, every serpent of failure, every serpent of rejection, every serpent of non-achievement in my life begin to run out, begin to run into fire, begin to run out, run into fire, 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 run out, run into fire. In the name of Jesus, every serpent of disfavor, run out and run into fire, run out and run into fire, run out and run into fire. Run out and run into fire. Yakasanda Baba Leporia. Run out and run into fire. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Serpent of disfavor. In my blood. Catch fire. Catch fire. Catch fire. Catch fire. Catch fire. In the name of Jesus. Serpent of disfavor. That is making me to have disfavor. Everywhere I go, I see catch fire. Burn to ashes. Catch fire. To ashes, catch fire, burn to ashes. In the name of Jesus, serpent of disfavor, I set on fire, I set on fire, I set on fire, I set on fire. Every serpent of disfavor in my life, be roasted by fire, be roasted by fire, be roasted by fire, be roasted by fire. In the name of Jesus, every serpent of disfavor in my life, every serpent of infirmity in my life, every serpent of satanic viruses in my life, in my wife's life, in my children's lives, be roasted by fire, be roasted by fire, be roasted by fire, be roasted by fire, be roasted by fire. For in Jesus' name we pray. Blood of Jesus, overshadow my life and protect me from strange viruses in the mighty name of Jesus. Blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus, overshadow my life, overshadow my wife's life, overshadow my children's lives, overshadow my parents' lives, overshadow my siblings' lives, overshadow the lives of members of this church, and protect us from strange satanic viruses. In the name of Jesus, protect us, O Lord, protect us, O Lord, protect us, O Lord. Blood of Jesus, immune us against strange satanic viruses that is going on all over the world, that is moving around the world. In the name of Jesus, blood of Jesus, protect me, protect my wife, protect my children, protect my parents, protect my siblings, protect members of this church. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, every strange virus in the air be destroyed by the power in the blood of Jesus, every skin virus, every coronavirus, every Ebola virus, every SARS in the air, be destroyed by the power in the blood of Jesus. Be destroyed by the fire of the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, I and my family will reject infirmity, will reject diseases and sicknesses, will reject afflictions, will reject satanic infections. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, anywhere I go, anywhere my wife goes, anywhere my children go, anywhere my parents go, anywhere my siblings go, anywhere members of this church go, blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus, protect us from satanic infections in the name of Jesus. Protect us from demonic infections in the name of Jesus. Protect us from viral infections, bacterial infections, fungus infections in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. For in Jesus' name we pray. So, O Lord, envelop me and my family with your fire in the name of Jesus. O Lord, my Father, envelop me and my family with your fire. Envelop me, envelop my wife, envelop my children with your fire. These strange diseases, these strange sicknesses that are going all over the place will not touch us in the name of Jesus. O Lord, my Father, envelop me, envelop every member of this church in Everton, Tampa, Florida with your fire, with your fire. Envelop of fire, envelop me and my family in the name of Jesus. Envelop of fire, envelop every member of MFM Tampa, Florida, in the name of Jesus. Every source of coronavirus, we destroy you by the power in the blood of Jesus. Every source of coronavirus, we destroy you by the power in the blood of Jesus. Every spread of coronavirus, we destroy you by the power in the blood of Jesus. Wherever the virus is right now, Holy Ghost fire, begin to burn them to ashes. Holy Ghost fire, begin to burn them to ashes. Holy Ghost fire, begin to burn them to ashes. Holy Ghost fire, begin to burn them to ashes. Holy Ghost fire, begin to burn them to ashes. In the name of Jesus. Mashakatari Baba. You are going to pray like this. Say, the evil wind that is blowing right now will not touch me and my family in the mighty name of Jesus. The evil wind that is blowing right now will not touch me and my family in the name of Jesus. The evil wind that is blowing right now will not touch me, will not touch my family in the name of Jesus. The evil wind of afflictions, the evil wind of infirmity, the evil wind of death that is blowing right now will not touch me, will not touch my wife, will not touch my children, will not touch my parents, will not touch my siblings, will not touch members of this church, will not touch my friends, will not touch anyone that is attached to me, that is close to me, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, the evil wind that is blowing right now, I command it to scatter, 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 in the name of Jesus. The wind of affliction, the wind of infirmity that is blowing right now, I'm not your candidate. My wife, my children, my parents, my siblings, members of this church, we are not your candidate. Therefore die, 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 in the name of Jesus. Wind of affliction, we are not your candidate. Die in the name of Jesus. 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 No affliction will touch me. No affliction will touch my wife. No affliction will touch my children. Because we are covered with the blood of Jesus. We are covered with the blood of Jesus. We are covered with the blood of Jesus. No affliction, no infirmity, no disease, no corona disease, no coronavirus will touch any member of this church in the mighty name of Jesus. Rapasakatarimala, you coronavirus will destroy your power in Tampa. We destroy your power in Florida. We destroy your power in America. We destroy your power all over the world in the mighty name of Jesus. Ramashika Leboni Baba Kaskendi Romeno Skanda Uli Karumena Skendi Leboria. Chop! In Jesus' name we pray.
Say, this year,
I will not spend my money on afflictions. In the mighty name of Jesus, this year, I, my wife, and my children, we will not spend our money on afflictions. In the mighty name of Jesus, this year, I, my wife, and my children, will not spend our money on afflictions. We will not spend our money on afflictions. We will not spend our money on infirmity. In the mighty name of Jesus, every power that wants me, my wife, and my children to spend our money on afflictions, on infirmity, you are a liar. That in the name of Jesus. 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 Yes. Any spirit, any power that wants me to spend my money, that wants my wife and my children to spend their money on afflictions, on infirmity, I command it to die. 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 For in Jesus' name we pray.
Say, I am not a candidate of disaster.
I, my wife, and my children, we are not candidates of disaster.
Therefore,
every disaster in this environment, scatter in the name of Jesus. I, my wife, and my children, we are not candidates of disaster. We are not candidates of calamity. We are not candidates of afflictions. Therefore, every calamity, every disaster, every affliction in this environment, scatter and die. Scatter and die. Scatter and die. Scatter and die. For in Jesus' name we pray.
Music.
We give glory to the Lord, he reigns. We give glory to the Lord, he reigns. He reigns, he reigns, he reigns. We give glory to the Lord, he reigns.
Music.
We give glory to the Lord, he reigns. We give glory to the Lord, he reigns. He reigns. We give glory to the Lord, he reigns. We give glory to the Lord, he reigns. We give glory to the Lord, he reigns. He reigns, he reigns, he reigns. We give glory to the Lord, he reigns. Adoration, adoration to the Lord, he reigns. We give glory to the Lord, he reigns. We give glory to the Lord, he reigns. He reigns, he reigns, he reigns. We give glory to the Lord, he reigns. Hallelujah. We give glory to the Lord, he reigns.
Hey!
We give glory to the Lord, he reigns.
Ah!
He reigns, he reigns, he reigns. We give glory to the Lord, he reigns. Almighty God, hallowed be your name. 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 I say, Almighty God, hallowed be your name. Almighty God, hallowed be your name. I say, Almighty God, hallowed be your name. Almighty God, you are worthy, you are worthy. You are worthy to be glorified. You are worthy, oh Lord, you are worthy. You are worthy to be glorified. You are worthy. You are worthy. You are worthy to be glorified. You are worthy, oh Lord, you are worthy. You are worthy to be glorified. Angels are singing, you are worthy, oh Lord. You are worthy, you are worthy, oh Lord. You are worthy, you are worthy, oh Lord. You are worthy, you are worthy. Your children are saying, you are worthy, oh Lord. You are worthy, you are worthy, oh Lord. You are worthy, Lord. You are worthy, Lord. Jehovah, El Shaddai. Kingdom kings, you are worthy, Lord. You are worthy, Lord. Jehovah, you are worthy, Lord. Ancient of days, you are worthy, Lord. You are worthy, Lord. Jehovah, you are worthy, Lord. We have the reasons to praise the Lord. We have the reasons to praise the Lord. In our lives, we have the reasons to praise the Lord. In the night, we have the reasons to praise the Lord. We have the reasons to praise Jehovah. We have the reasons to praise the Lord. In our lives, reasons to praise the Lord. We have the reasons to praise the Lord. Hallelujah, 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 praise the Lord. Hallelujah, 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 praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, praise the Lord. By Jesus conquer Satan. Hallelujah, 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 praise the Lord. Hallelujah, 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 praise the Lord. Hallelujah, 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 praise the Lord. By Jesus conquer Satan. Who is greater than Jehovah El Shaddai? There is no one greater than Jehovah El Shaddai. Who is greater than Jehovah El Shaddai? There is no one greater than Jehovah El Shaddai. Marvelous, marvelous Jehovah, excellent Jehovah. There is no one greater than Jehovah El Shaddai. Excellent Jehovah, marvelous Jehovah. There is no one greater than Jehovah. Jesus died on the cross, saving me on the cross, healing me on the cross to redeem me. Jesus died on the cross, saving me on the cross, healing me on the cross to redeem me. Hallelujah, he arose. Hallelujah, he arose. Hallelujah, he arose to redeem me. Hallelujah, he arose. Hallelujah, he arose. Hallelujah, he arose to redeem me. The most excellent is Jesus. Shout hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah, the most excellent is Jesus. Hallelujah, shout hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah, amen, hallelujah, amen, hallelujah, amen, hallelujah. Amen, hallelujah, amen, hallelujah, amen. Ah, in the house of God. Hallelujah, joy in the house of God. In the house of God, oh. Hallelujah, joy in the house of God. We are joy, hallelujah, joy. Hallelujah, joy. We shall meet on that day. Joy, 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 hallelujah, joy, hallelujah, joy, we shall meet on that day. Amen. Before you sit down, pray this prayer. Say, my life will not become hell on earth. In the mighty name of Jesus, my life will not become hell on earth, in the mighty name of Jesus. My life, my wife's life, my children's lives will not become hell on earth, in the name of Jesus. Any power that is programming my life to become hell on earth, I command it to fall down and die, in the name of Jesus. Every power that wants me to suffer, every power that wants me to struggle, every power
that wants my destiny to be turned upside down. Wherever you may be, let the fire of the Holy Ghost begin to destroy you now. In the name of Jesus, let the thunder fire of the living God begin to destroy you now. In the name of Jesus, every covenant of hardship in my life, I destroy you. I destroy your power. I destroy your stronghold. In the name of Jesus, every covenant of hardship, every covenant of rough life, every covenant of struggling, every covenant of lack, every covenant, yes, of poverty, in my life, in my wife, in my children, I destroy your power. I destroy your stronghold. I destroy your power. I destroy your stronghold. I destroy your power. I destroy your stronghold. In the name of Jesus, every covenant that fought my parents, that is now fighting me, break by the power in the blood of Jesus. Every covenant that fought my every covenant that fought my parents that are now fighting me, break by fire, 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 break by fire. In the name of Jesus, every covenant of poverty, every covenant of failure, every covenant of non-achievement, every covenant of lack, every covenant of struggling that fought my parents, I am not your candidate. My children, my children's children, they are not your candidate. Therefore break, 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 in the name of Jesus. Break in the name of Jesus. For in Jesus' name we pray. Father, once again we thank you for bringing us to this mountain. You that has brought us here, fight our battles. Give us victory and about. Open every good door that the wicked has shut against our destinies. In the mighty name of Jesus, every army of darkness that is waging war against our lives, let the army of the Lord, the hosts of heaven, begin to scatter them in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. For in Jesus' name we are praying. Amen. Let us see that. God bless you in the name of Jesus. This afternoon we are looking at the topic, the destructive, amen, strange fires in your bones. The destructive, strange fires in your bones. Amen. I say there is this sensation inside the bone of every man, every woman, called strange fire. This strange fire has put millions and millions of men and women in trouble in our lives. From the very beginning of creation, strange fire. Amen. Strange fire has been at from the very beginning of creation. And has caused a major problem, amen, for mankind. I want you to pray like this. Every strange fire.
Every strange fire.
Every strange fire. You need to pray. Every strange fire. In my bone. Programmed to put me in trouble. Die in the name of Jesus. Every strange fire. In my bones, programmed to put me in trouble, I command it to die. In the name of Jesus, every strange fire in my bones, in my wife's bones, in my children's bones, programmed to put us in trouble, I command it to die. 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 For in Jesus' name we pray. Hallelujah. The Lord will help us see that. God bless you. I say from the very beginning of creation, strange fire has been a major problem of mankind. And a lot of people have been destroyed. A lot of people have been maimed. A lot of people have been killed. A lot of people have been buried because of the inability to control the strange fires in their lives. Strange fire! In the name of Jesus, strange fire burning in my bones, burning in my wife's bones, burning in my children's bones. I command you to die. I command you to die. I command you to die. Satanic strange fire, destructive strange fire burning in my bones. I command you to die. 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 Every destructive strange fire that is burning in my bones, that is burning in my wife's bones, that is burning in my children's bones, that is burning in the bones of members of this church, I command it to die. I command it to die. I command it to die. For in Jesus' name we pray. I say a lot of men and women have buried their destinies because of their inability to tame the destructive strange fire in their bones. Any strange fire in my bones, shout it loud and clear. Any strange fire in my bones, programmed to bury my destiny, you are a liar. In the name of Jesus, any strange fire in my bones, programmed to bury my destiny, any strange fire in my wife's bones, in my children's bones, in the bones of members of this church, programmed to bury our destinies, programmed to bury our glory, I command it to die. 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 For in Jesus' name we pray. As we're going into the Bible, we have seen so many examples of the destructive power of strange fires. We have seen many examples of the destructive power of strange fires in the lives of men and women. You are going to shout it again. Destructive strange fires. You will not destroy my life. Therefore, in the name of Jesus, destructive strange fires. You will not destroy my life. You will not destroy my wife's life. You will not destroy my children's lives. You will not destroy the lives of my siblings, the lives of members of this church. Therefore, die. Therefore, die. Therefore, die. Therefore, die. For in Jesus' name we pray. I say some examples. Let us look at some examples of strange fire, destructive strange fire, in the lives of men and women in the Bible. Nadab and Abihu. Praise the Lord. We need to pray this afternoon. Leviticus chapter 10 verse 1. Leviticus chapter 10 verse 1. And Nadab and Abihu, the sons of Aaron, took either of them a censer and put fire therein, and put incense thereof, and offered strange fire before the Lord, which he commanded them not. I said, the sons of Aaron, Nadab and Abihu, they were sons of a prophet. They were like the sons of the modern day pastor. They knew God, and they knew their limits. They knew what God wanted, and they knew what God did not want. Unfortunately, there was a strange fire in their bones that was going to push them to do that which will destroy them. You are going to pray like this. Any strange fire in my bones. Shouting louder than that. Any strange fire in my bones, pushing me to do what would destroy me. You are a liar. in the name of Jesus. In my bones, in my wife's bones, in my children's bones, in my parents' bones, in my siblings' bones, in the bones of members of Amazon Tampa, Florida, that is pushing us to do that which will destroy us. Die in the name of Jesus. Die in the name of Jesus. Die in the name of Jesus. For in Jesus' name we pray. I said, despite knowing that some things were abominations in the sight of God, Nadab and Abihu still could not control the power of the destructive strange fire in their lives. They have been offering incense before today, before then. But that day God did not command them. So anything I am doing, I command it to die. 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 Anything I am doing that God has not commanded me, anything my wife is doing that God has not commanded her, anything my children are doing that God has not commanded them, anything members of this church and Metro Tampa, Florida are doing that God has not commanded us that can destroy us, I command it to die. 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 In the name of Jesus, there is somebody on this line that is hearing the sound of my voice. That thing that you are doing, that God has not commanded you, that has been programmed to destroy you, I command it to die. 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 In the name of Jesus, anything in my life that I am doing, that God has not commanded me, that wants to destroy me, that has been programmed to destroy me, I command it to die. 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 Yes.
Die in the name of Jesus.
For in Jesus, I will pray. This is what has finished a lot of people. The strange fire, the destructive strange fire that is burning in their bones. Some people will tell you, they say, I don't know, Pastor, I cannot control myself. I said the strange fire in their bones, in the bones of Nadab and Abihu, it may still push them to offer a strange physical fire. Leviticus chapter 10 verse 2, the verse 2 said, And there went out fire from the Lord and devoured them, and they died before the Lord. The sons of Aaron, a high priest, a very high level prophet, the children definitely are not novice to the laws of the temple, but something in them that was going to kill them that day push them. So anything in my life, that is pushing me for my destruction, anything in my life pushing me to my destruction, expire, die in the name of Jesus. Anything in my life, anything in my wife's life, anything in my children's lives, anything in the life of members of this church that is pushing us to our destruction, I command it to die. I command it to die. I command it to die.
For in Jesus' name we pray.
I said, despite the fact that they were sons of the prophets, they probably grew up in the temple and knew the temple rules. But there was a straight fire in their bones that was going to bury them before their time. Any straight fire in my bones, Somebody is hearing the sound of my voice shouting loud. Any strange fire in my bones. Programmed to bury me before my time. You're a liar. Die. In the name of Jesus, any strange fire. In my bones, in my wife's bones, in my children's bones, in my parents' bones, in my siblings' bones, in the bones of members of this church, programmed to bury us before our time. Die in the name of Jesus. Die in the name of Jesus. Die in the name of Jesus. For in Jesus' name we pray. What is burying some people? What has buried some people is the fire, the strange fire in their bones. I say God is not a respecter of persons. If you offer any strange fire, he did not command you. You may never live to tell the story. Acts chapter 10 verse 34. The Bible says, then Peter opened his mouth. Acts 10 34. Then Peter opened his mouth and said, of a truth I perceived that God is no respecter of persons. A lot of Christians, they are joking with grace now. Says grace is sufficient. And they are doing things that God has not commanded them. They do not know that they are listening to the voice of the destructive fire in their bones. So the voice of the destructive fire in my bones. Jesus, the voice of the destructive strange fire in my bones. For in Jesus' name we pray. No, it was the voice of that destructive strange fire that spoke to David on the day when kings went to war and don't go to war. Sleep on your bed. And the same voice of the strange fire in his bones made him to go and climb on top of the roof to see a naked woman that was bathing. And the same strange voice told him, he said, tell that woman to come so that you can sleep with her. And what came after? Disaster and calamity. For in Jesus' name we pray. I say be careful, do not dare God. Our God is a consuming fire. He does not respect covenant violators. Don't risk your life violating the covenant of God. It is not worth it. It will only bring death and destruction. Unfortunately, a lot of men and women are offering destructive strange fire to the Lord. But they do not know that they are only destroying themselves. A lot of pastors, ministers, church workers, church members are offering destructive strange fire to the Lord. Just like the sons of Nadab or the sons of Aaron. Nadab and Abihu. Not knowing that they are only destroying their own lives. Praise the Lord. So let us look at another biblical example. It was King Uzziah. The Bible said, and he loved God, the king. The king so empowered him during his time, he created him an engine that was shooting arrows. And he was winning all manner of battles. His fame spread abroad. He loved God. God also loved him. Praise the Lord.
But one day, the strange fire in his bones was going to push him to have a label of leprosy on his forehead. Typical example in the Bible of a king that offered destructive strange fire to the Lord, and the Lord did not waste time in baptizing him with leprosy. Let us look at 2 Chronicles chapter 26 verse 17 to 21. 2 Chronicles 26 17 to 20. May you never do anything that will bring spiritual leprosy upon your life in the name of Jesus. And Azariah the priest went in after him. What happened? After he had recorded a lot of success and his fame had spread abroad, he became very proud. There was a destructive strange fire in his bones that started speaking. Say, King Uzziah, King Uzziah, go into the temple and go and burn incense to the Lord. And Azariah the priest went in after him, and with him false called priests of the Lord. 80 priests, they ran after him when he entered the temple. Ah, king, don't do this. It is not in your position. Amen. That were valiant men. The Bible says, and they withstood Uzziah. Sometimes you are telling some people, don't destroy yourself, but they are not listening. Amen. They withstood Uzziah the king and said unto him, it appertaineth not unto thee, Uzziah, to burn incense unto the Lord. It is not in your position. You are a king. This thing is for the priests. Praise the Lord. But to the priest, the sons of Aaron. Did you see it there? But to the priest, the sons of Aaron. So the sons of Aaron that died, they actually had the right to burn incense. But they did it on a day when God did not command them. That's why one must not take God for granted. God is a killing machine. That are consecrated to burn incense, the sons of Aaron that were consecrated to burn incense. So which means the boys that died were actually consecrated, but on that day God did not command them. There are sometimes you actually do the right thing at the wrong time. I pray for you. You are hearing the sound of my voice. Your problem is that you are doing the right thing but at the wrong time. The heaven will correct it for you today in the name of Jesus. From today, you begin to do the right things at the right time by the power and the blood of Jesus. That are consecrated to burn incense, go out of the sanctuary, for thou hast trespassed. Neither shall it be for thy honor from the Lord God. Then Uzziah was wroth. He was angry. They said they are trying to prevent a little chick from dying because the hawks will carry it. But the chick is angry that they are not allowing it to roam about. Say, leave me, let me roam about. But the mother chicken, he said, hey, you with that? They told him, Uzziah was rough. And had a censer in his hand to burn incense. And while he was rough with the priest, the leprosy even rose up in his forehead before the priest in the house of the Lord, from beside the incense altar. And Azariah the chief priest and all the priests looked upon him, and behold, he was leprous in his forehead. Look at God. Look at where he put the leprosy. Why did he put it on the forehead? So that everybody can see it. And in Israel, once you have leprosy, you cannot come near human beings again. You'll be cast into the leper colony. Praise the Lord. So he put it on his forehead where everybody can see.
Say, my father! Remove anything and everything in my life. That can bring shame upon my life. In the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, my father, remove from my life. Remove from my wife's life. Remove from my children's life. Remove from my parents' life.
Anything in our lives that can bring shame and disgrace upon us, in the name of Jesus, Father, remove it. For in Jesus' name we pray. A whole king became leprous. Something was in him that attracted shame and disgrace.
Anything in my wife's life, anything in my children's life, attracting shame and disgrace, die, 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 yes.
For in Jesus' name we pray. You can see what was bringing, what brings shame to a man or a woman's life is inside them. The destructive strange fire. They even wanted, they said, stop king, stop king, stop, stop, stop. He was even angry. And he was born. So that voice was saying, do it, do it, do it, do it. The Bible says, and he was leprous in his forehead, and they thrust him out from thence. Yea, himself hasted also to go out, because the Lord has smitten him. And Uzziah the king was a leper unto the day of his death because of one simple mistake. And they want him. Just like God wants us every day. And he dwell in a several house, being a leper. With me, he dwell in a leper's house. He came. For he was cut off from the house of the Lord. And Jotham, his son, was over the king's house, judging the people of the land. God does not spare violators, no matter how close you may think you are to him, no matter how strong your relationship with him may be. A lot of people are shouting all over, grace, 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 grace. It's not grace. Amen. It is mercy. The other Bible examples of destructive straight fire, which is what is plaguing our world today, is indiscriminate sexual immoralities. Indiscriminate sexual immoralities. Nearly everybody is a victim now. Even bishops, general overseers, high priests, prophets, apostles are falling victim to indiscriminate sexual immoralities programmed from the bottom of the sea. All manner of sexual immoralities is sending terrible, destructive, straight fire to heaven. And a lot of people don't understand that this may be the secret behind their unresolvable problems. A father sleeping with his own daughter, what kind of fire is he sending? Amen. A son-in-law sleeping with his mother-in-law, what kind of fire is he sending to heaven? A man sleeping with two sisters at the same time, what kind of fire is he sending to heaven? Praise the Lord. Number one, masturbating Onan. Masturbating Onan. A man in the Bible called Onan was pouring his semen on the ground. A similar exercise, or a similar exercise to modern day masturbation. And the anger of the Lord kindled against him and he died. When I was reading this scripture, I became even more fearful, more afraid for all those that are masturbating. In Genesis chapter 37 verse 7 and Genesis chapter 38 verse 7 to 10. Genesis 38 7 to 8. The Bible says, and here Judah's firstborn was wicked in the sight of the Lord, even though the Bible didn't tell us the wickedness. But from what happened subsequently, we were able to infer what must have happened. And the Lord slew him, the Lord slaughtered him. Say, anything in my life that will cause God to slaughter me, in the name of Jesus, any destructive strange fire in my bones, in my wife's bones, in my children's bones, yes, that will cause God to slaughter us, die in the name of Jesus, die in the name of Jesus, die in the name of Jesus, die in the name of Jesus. For in Jesus' name we pray. And Judah said unto Onan, go in unto thy brother's wife and marry her, and raise up seed to thy brother. And Onan knew that the seed should not be his. And it came to pass, when he went in unto his brother's wife, that he spilled it on the ground. Is it in your Bible? What do they do in masturbation? They spill it on the ground. Lest that he should give seed to his brother. And the thing which he did displeased the Lord. Wherefore he slew him also. Anything in my wife's life, anything in my children's lives that is displeasing you, Father, kill them now. Father, kill them now. Father, kill those things now. Instead of us to die, Father, kill the things of Lord. Father, kill those strange fires. Anything in my life that is displeasing God, die in the name of Jesus. Die in the name of Jesus. For in Jesus' name we pray. The semen of a man is created by God to produce seeds, children, through a woman. God does not take it kindly at all. When a man begins to waste this semen through masturbation or any withdrawal from the woman and spilling it on the ground like Onan did, you can see that the punishment here was death. Everybody is shouting pro-life, pro-life, pro-life. They are facing those that are aborting babies, but they are not looking at those that are even throwing the seed away. It's the same crime. The person that committed abortion and the person that committed masturbation, they have committed the same crime. It's the same pro-life. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. The Bible says, only God knows what error his brother too did before God slew him. But looking at the account that Judah, their father, slept with and impregnated the same wife of his, the same woman, the wife of Er, Judah gave her to the younger brother. Judah slept with the same woman again. You can see they have a problem in that family. Pray this prayer. Every foundation of sexual immorality,
every foundation of sexual
in my life, in my wife's life, in my children's lives, die! In the name of Jesus, every foundation of sexual immorality in my life, in my wife's life, in my children's lives, in my children's lives, in the lives of members of this church, Jesus never pray. Yes, some people, they come from foundations of terrible sexual immorality. That's why they can't control themselves. Because it is in their foundation. And Psalm 11 verse 3 says, if the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? I said it was very obvious that sexual immorality was one destructive strange fire. Amen. That the household was offering unto God. That the household of Judah was offering unto God, and the result was calamity and disaster.
Who knows? Maybe it is the punishment for your masturbation that is killing good things in your life. Because sometimes you may not die in person, but good things are gradually dying in your life.
Genesis 38:24-26.
And it came to pass about 3 months after that it was told Judah, saying, Tamar, thy daughter-in-law, had played the harlot, and also behold, she is with child by whoredom.
Not knowing that it was her father-in-law that went to sleep with a prostitute, not knowing that that was his daughter-in-law that impregnated her.
Sex. And Judah said, bring her forth and let her be burnt.
Look at the judgment. Look at the man committing immorality outside, but wants to burn somebody inside that got caught because she's pregnant.
When she was brought forth, she said to her father-in-law, saying,
by the man, whose these are, I am with a child. The man that owns these things. And she said, the son, I pray thee. He told the man, say, the son, no. I pray thee. Whose are these? Look at the man. His signet, bracelet, and star. 3 things because he wanted sex. You can see that they have a sexual problem in that family.
I said, it was so terrible. The strange fire of sexual immorality was so hot in the bones of Judah that he had sex on credit. He didn't have money. So he had sex on credit, using his signet, bracelet, and staff as collateral to collect them at a later day when he brought payment. You can see that Father Judah and his sons, heir and owner, just had a straight fire of sexual immorality burning in their bones. Pray for your children now. Anti-destructive straight fire. Of sexual immorality burning in the bones of my children. In the name of Jesus, any destructive state fire of sexual immorality burning in the bones of my children.
For Jesus' name, they are dead. Don't say it doesn't concern you.
Hey,
you better pray. The children of nowadays, they are up to a lot of things. The Lord will deliver us in Jesus' name.
Genesis 38:26. And Judah acknowledged them and said, she had been more righteous than I, because that I gave her not to Salem my son.
Look at the excuse. And they knew her again no more. He said, well, she's more righteous than me because I didn't give heart to my son. I didn't want my son to die again. That's what we're talking about. Or that he went to go and collabas your daughter-in-law. Praise the Lord.
Sometimes, just like heir and owner, you may inherit a destructive straight fire of sexual immorality. Every destructive straight fire of sexual immorality.
Every destructive straight fire.
Jesus, every destructive, strange sexual fire of sexual immorality that I inherited from my parents that wants to bury my glory. I said that. 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 I said that.
For in Jesus' name we pray. A lot of people, what they inherited from their parents, sexual immorality, have buried their glory already. The same thing, buried the glory of their parents. I say you need to quickly deal with it before it destroys you.
Another man in the Bible whose destiny was destroyed by a straight destructive fire in his bones was Reuben,
the first son of Jacob. On one very terrible day, he was going to remember for the rest of his life, as if there were not women in Israel. The destructive straight fire of sexual immorality arose in his bones. And his inability to quench it
made him have sex with his own father's concubine. Do you know how many thousands of women that were in Israel that time looking for a man? He went after his father's concubine. This strange fire in his bones. And his destiny was shut down. Of course, Genesis 49, 3 to 4, you remember the story. He said, and Jacob called all his sons and said, I want to tell you what will befall you on your last days. He now said, oh man, you are my firstborn, the excellency of my power. Amen. He said, unstable as water. He said, Reuben, thou shalt not excel because you went on your father's couch. Because of that strange fire, he could not resist that day. That strange fire did not allow him to remember that this is daddy's wife. The destructive strange fire of sexual immorality completely buried his glory and destiny. A lot of men and women like Reuben, the firstborn of Jacob today, amen, and their glory and their destiny has been buried already. A woman with a very hot, destructive, straight fire in her bones, amen, was another example, and that was Potiphar's wife. Genesis 39:7. The Bible says, and it came to pass after these things that his master's wife cast her eyes upon Joseph, and she said, lie with me. Every evil eye that is cast on me in order to destroy me, die in the name of Jesus. Every evil eye that is cast on me, that is cast on my wife, that is cast on my children, that is cast on members of this church in order to destroy us, I command you to die, 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 die. For in Jesus' name we pray. In Genesis 39:10, the Bible says, and it came to pass as she spake to Joseph day by day. You can see that the fire was very hot in her bones. Day by day, that he hearkened not unto her. Thank God for the spirit in the life of Joseph to lie by her or to be with her. Genesis 39:12 was the crescendo. The Bible says, and she caught him by his garment, that whether you like it or not, today, today, you must do it. How can they are giving you food to eat by force? Say, I'm not eating. Say, yeah, you must eat. It was a strange fire of sexual immorality in the life of Potiphar's wife that was driving her crazy. And a lot of people have been driven like that, men and women. The sexual, the destructive strange fire of sexual immorality is pushing them like a mad cow. Praise the Lord. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. And she caught him. Genesis 39:2. And she caught him by his garment, saying, lie with me. And he left his garment in her hand and fled and got him out. if it is you, won't you do the same thing? He ran. So I say, what then is destructive strange fire? What is destructive strange fire? Genesis 39:8-9. He said, but he refused and said unto his master's wife, behold, my master wanted not what is with me in the house, and had committed all that he had to my hands. There is none greater in this house than I, neither had kept back anything from me but thee. I'm in charge of everything but you. The woman said, but add me to the list. The man said, no, I will not add you, because thou art his wife. How then can I do this great wickedness and sin against God? I said, therefore, what is destructive strange fire? Destructive strange fire is any wickedness you do and sin against God. Any wickedness you do and you sin against God is a destructive strange fire. It is anything you do that God has not commanded you to do and also displeases God. Those are strange fires. It is doing things that are completely contrary to the will of God that is making you to stink before God. That's destructive strange fire. It is being rebellious to the word of God. The word of God said this, but you are doing something opposite. Amen. It is following the evil patterns of the world that makes heaven to weep. Look at all the things that are happening now all over the world. Some people say no, they don't want to get married. Some people say they are getting married, but they have to do it that in a way that is contrary to the word of God.
strange fire everywhere. People are having children now, without marriage. They say, no, we don't need to get married. Let's just have it. And when they get tired of themselves, everybody go their separate ways and go and marry some other people again. Strange fires. But how can you avoid offering strange fire unto the Lord? Give your life to Christ. Study and meditate on the word of God. 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 15 says, study to show yourself approved unto God. Amen. A workman that needed not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of the truth. I say, know the word of God so that Satan does not take advantage of you. If you don't know the word of God, he will sell sand for you and he will say it is powder. Know the word of God so that Satan does not take advantage of you. Live a holy and a righteous life. Be prayerful and be watchful. Say, watch and pray. Praise the Lord. Be like Joseph. Don't give in to destructive strange fires. Be like him. No matter how pleasurable the presentation may be, don't take it. There are some gifts, there are gifts of death. Go and ask Samson. Delilah offered him something pleasurable, but he ended up two eyes gone, grinding meal in the house of his enemies, and eventually he died because of free gift from Delilah. Let us rise up. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. It was the strange fire in Samson that destroyed him. Remember, the first wife he had was a daughter of the Philistines. The father said, it is against the custom of Israel. You can't do this. He said, no, I love her. Give her to me now. I must marry her. And trouble started from there. From there, he went to a prostitute, harlot in Gaza. He left Gaza. He went to the Valley of Zurich to go and meet professor of prostitution, Delilah, the one that buried him completely. A woman was telling him, "Say, tell me the secret of your power so that I can afflict you." But the fire inside him did not allow him to have sex. You know, when this fire is burning, sometimes men, women lose their brains. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Lay your right hand on your head and shout like this. Say, my Father! Destroy every strange fire. Burn me in my bones. In the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, my Father. Destroy every strange fire. Burn in my bones, burn in my wife's bones, burn in my children's bones before they destroy us. Father, destroy them before they destroy me. Father, destroy the strange fire in my bones before it destroys me. In the name of Jesus, destroy. Pray for yourself. For in Jesus' name we pray. I pray that this destructive strange fire that is burning your bones will not destroy you. In the name of Jesus. Instead, the fire of the Holy Ghost will swallow it. Amen. And the fire of God will begin to burn in your bones. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Let's take our tithe and offering very quickly. Hallelujah. From Mountain of Fire Miracles Ministries, Tampa, Florida. It's a deliverance ministry. We do deliverance here. Amen. Counseling, prayer counseling. If you want to contact us, our contact details are on our Facebook and our website. God bless you in the name of Jesus. We want to invite you to join us in the church hall so that you can be part of this prayer meeting. Not just watching us online. God bless you in the name of Jesus. Let us rise. Everlasting Father, the Shekinah King of Glory, the God that made it possible for us to come to this mountain this afternoon. And we believe that you have killed and
destroyed every destructive street fire in our bones. Father, let us burn for Jesus. Don't let us burn for destruction. Don't let us burn for death. In the mighty name of Jesus. And if there's any power anywhere, because the Bible says we will not be unaware of the devices of the wicked. That is programming strange fire into the bones of anyone here, or anyone hearing the sound of my voice, in order to destroy them. Father, let such powers be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Let such powers be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Let such powers be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Because you are the bishop of our souls. You are the glory and the lifter of our heads. And we know you will always watch over us. Because you are the God that watches over Israel. That neither sleep nor slumber. We raise this tithe and offering unto you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Father, accept it. Enlarge our coast. Devour our devourers. Breathe upon our businesses, career, investments, and finances. In the name of Jesus. Enlarge the coast of this church by your mighty power. Thank you, Father, because we are coming back in the evening for the Bible studies. Father, let us meet with you again and learn at your feet. In the name of Jesus. As we go, we cover ourselves with the blood of Jesus. No evil shall befall anyone here. Any power that is waiting, laying ambush anywhere, because of the prayers we are praying on this mountain this afternoon, Father, destroy them with your thunder. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, because the rest of the week shall be glorious, filled with uncommon testimonies and uncommon breakthroughs in our lives. For in Jesus' name we are prayed. Let us share the grace now. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Simple, powerful, hallelujah. Let's go. Hallelujah. 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 God bless you. Thank you for coming.